Hi everyone, my name is Jose Soler and I work on the design for repair team at Microsoft. We're going to be disassembling the Surface Hub 2S 50-inch. Detailed instructions are available in our service guides that are posted on the Microsoft support site. I'll be demonstrating the disassembly process on the 50-inch version of this device. The disassembly steps for the 2S 85-inch device are similar, but there are important differences which can be found in the service guide, especially in how we handle the device given the larger dimensions and weight. Repair should be performed on an ESD work surface with grounding to protect the device. Also, we recommend removing jewelry like watches and rings. In addition, be sure to use the Windows system to shut down the device completely for any repair. The tools needed for the disassembly are a 4mm and an 8mm Allen wrench, cutting pliers, a Phillips No. 1, T4, T6, T10 Torx screwdriver. Today we'll focus on the disassembly of the bump region of the device, which is this central region that houses all the field serviceable components for the device. Before starting the repair, the device will be disconnected from a power source and set on a secure, stable surface. Keep in mind that the surface hub is very heavy. It requires at a minimum two people to lift and move the unit. The product safety warnings and instructions for surface hub are published on the support.microsoft.com website and include the following heavy ergonomic lifting instructions. The first component we'll remove is a compute module, which contains the main board, most input and output ports, and the SSD for the device. Note that this module can be removed while the device is still mounted on a wall or stand, but for purposes of the video, we've set the device flat so we can demonstrate the removal of other components. We'll slide the latch to reveal a Phillips head screw. We'll use a Phillips screwdriver to unfasten the screw. Note that this screw is actually captive by design, so even when the screw is unfastened, it will not come out of the unit. With one hand, we'll grab the screw and the other we'll use it to hold onto the compute module and pull away from the device. We'll flip it over to expose the SSD door. Again, we'll use a Phillips head screwdriver to remove a screw. An additional screw secures the SSD. We will remove it with a Phillips No. 1 driver. The SSD will now be accessible and can be removed by hand. Note that customers with a newer model may also find a thermal pad underneath the SSD. To remove the SSD, the same steps can be followed to complete the removal. If the SSD is removed on this newer model, we recommend replacing the thermal pad to obtain optimal performance once the SSD is replaced. To access the remaining components, we will remove the bump cover. It is held with four mounting pucks, which we will remove with a 4mm Allen key. Next, we have four hex nuts, which we'll remove with the 8mm hex key. The cover is at this point only retained with snap clips. It can now be removed by pulling up. At this point, we can now access all the remaining field replaceable components for the device. For example, we have the video board, compute fan, base speaker, power supply unit or PSU, and the power supply fan. I'll note that the components at this point are all modular, but for today, we'll start with the compute module fan. We will remove the fan cable from the video board and then use a T10 driver to remove three screws. The fan can now be removed by pulling upward. Next, we'll cover the power supply fan. We'll start by disconnecting the fan from the video board. We will then carefully use our cutting pliers to cut the zip ties to release the cable bundles. After the cables are free, we will carefully remove them from the routing hooks. At this point, three screws will hold the fan. We will remove them with a T10 driver. To remove the fan, we'll carefully lift it up, watching for any cables that may get caught with the fan routing hooks. Next, we'll remove the base speaker. Similar to the fan, we'll disconnect the speaker from the video board. Then, we will remove three screws using a T10 driver. We will then lift the speaker up and away from the device. Next, we will remove the video board. We will start by removing a screw from the display cable retention latch. We'll use a T4 for this. There is some light adhesive also retaining the latch, which can be overcome by gently pulling up. The two display cables can be removed at this point. Before proceeding, peel the copper tape between the video board and the power supply. We will then remove five screws from the video board using a T6 driver. And one screw from the heatsink using a T10 driver. At this point, we'll disconnect the remaining cables from the video board and remove the board from the device. The last component we'll work on today is the power supply, or PSU. We'll use a T10 bit to remove four screws from the PSU. After removing the screws, complete the disassembly by removing the display cable from the PSU. With this, we have completed the disassembly of the device. A few things to note. During reassembly, make sure there aren't any screws or foreign objects inside the device. After finishing the assembly, remember to attach the SSD and connect it to a power supply to get it to power on. I hope you found this video useful. Check the Microsoft site for more information or to learn about Microsoft sustainability efforts.